Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. Today I want to show you how to make watermelon and melon granita. Granita is a frozen dessert, was originated in Sicily, and it's very similar to Italian ice. But in granita they use sugar, water, and real fruit. And because June is a month of watermelons, I've decided to make watermelon and also melon granita. In Russia, they let you taste the watermelon before you buy it. They cut like a little wedge in it. But here I had a hard time finding a good one. And you never know which one you get. I tried to do the tapping method and hopefully I got a really good one. And I also got this beautiful melon. So we're gonna make granita. But first we need to make a simple syrup, which is pretty much an equal amount of water and sugar. And here I have 2 cups of sugar and 2 cups of water. We're gonna put it in a little saucepan and we're gonna mix it and just bring it to a boil. And our simple syrup is ready. And if you guys don't use all of it, you can use it in the different desserts too. Transfer your simple syrup in a small container and we need to cool it to room temperature. Moving on to cutting your watermelon, and I'm going to show you a very unique way to cut your watermelon. And of course you're going to cut it in half and then you're going to inspect your fruit and see if it's ripe enough. This one looks actually pretty good. Turn your watermelon upside down or with the cut side down so it looks like a dome. And we're gonna do the trimming method of cutting the watermelon, which means we're gonna go all the way around trimming that skin. The reason I like this method because it allows you to see where there is any white left on the watermelon. And if you see any white, you can just trim it. And this way, it's gonna be easier for us to cut the watermelon. So now we have a perfectly trimmed watermelon. And to cut it into cubes, we're gonna cut it from the top into little strips, then cut it again across, and then cut it lengthwise. And then we got tons of watermelon cubes. The same method we're gonna apply for our melon. And I believe this one's called canary melon, maybe because it's yellow, but it smelled really good. So that's why I got this one. But you guys can use cantaloupe or you could use any type of melon you like. And you need to scrape down the seeds from in the middle of the melon. And of course you just need to discard them. And then you're just gonna go do the same thing. You're gonna trim the skin all the way around and you're gonna cut it into little cubes. And then you're gonna load your watermelon cubes into either food processor or a blender, whichever one you have, and we're just gonna give it a spin so it turns into pretty much juice. So pour that juice into a container, preferably in the measuring cup. What we're looking for, 6 cups of watermelon juice. Now into these 6 cups of watermelon juice, we're gonna pour 1 cup of simple syrup. We're gonna mix it, and then I'm gonna show you how to tell you when you have enough sugar in your watermelon juice. We're just gonna drop the egg. And just a plain egg. And if it doesn't float to the top, you need to add a little bit more of that simple syrup. So mix it again, then drop the egg again. And when the egg floats to the top, you can just guys see, then you see there's a little bit of the egg showing. It means you have enough sugar. And what sugar does in this dessert, it's pretty much serves as a stabilizer, because if you don't add enough sugar to your fruit is gonna separate into solids and water, and you will not be able to unmold your granita, and it's not gonna taste good. So we're gonna do the same thing with our melon. And the rest of it is pretty simple. You just need to pour your watermelon granita and your melon granita into glass containers, preferably with the lid. And we're gonna freeze them. And it depends on your freezer how fast you can freeze them, but mine took about 5 hours. And if you have that simple syrup left, you can just pour it in a container and store it, because you can use it in a lot of different things. You can make smoothies with it, you can make cocktails with it. As far as serving your granita, you're gonna need an ice cream scoop, and of course serve it on a hot day, not in the middle of January. And if you guys don't think my hand is cold when I'm trying to form the granita, you're mistaken. It's really cold. But, you know, I washed my hands yesterday. So just put it in a nice glass, and I like to use those martini glasses for granita. If you guys want to be a little bit more creative and want to impress your guests, and let's say you serve it for a dinner party or like on a hot day for barbecue, you can even pour some rum on top of that granita, so you have sort of like a cocktail. And then taste your granita. It's, guys, absolutely delicious. It's not like just the ice with the syrup poured over it. It has all natural ingredients, pretty much just three ingredients, which is fruit, real fruit, some sugar, and water. And you can really enjoy this dessert. I hope you guys like this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you soon.